Welcome back, everybody, to the Kansas Jayhawks Dynasty, where today we begin Season 2 on a big game in our Week 1 matchup. We are facing off against the number 25th ranked Nebraska Cornhuskers. Obviously, they no longer have Adrian Martinez, but this team still looks to have one of their best seasons to date as they start out ranked top 25 this year. Now, if you missed the offseason live stream, you did miss a few key parts of the offseason. We brought in a new talented junior receiver from community college, James Smith. He's got the height and he's got the speed, and I expect him to be a big contribution to this offense. But if he can't, we also brought back Stephen McBride, who was very close to transferring, but we were able to convince him not to leave. And we promised that he'd get enough playing time. However, unfortunately, on the quarterback side of things, Jalen Daniels figured it would be best for him to transfer out to the University of California to get some more playing time. We'll follow his story down there. But before we do any of that, let's get down to the field in Memorial Stadium as the Jayhawks take on the Cornhuskers and see if we can make a massive upset week one. As we are going to get underway here in Season 2, Trevor Wilson takes the kick in the end zone and kneels it down. And that's going to lead Jason Bean and company out onto the field now as Gardner's going to get it on the first play of the day. Nothing going there. Second and 11 now after Miles Farmer gets the tackle for loss. Bean in the shotgun on second down. He's going to give it to Smith across the middle and an easy catch and run for about 13 and a Jayhawk first down. Now second and 8 just a few plays later. Bean out of the shotgun. Play action. Hit hard. Almost lost that as a fumble, but he is able to throw it away. Third and 8 now. Jason Bean out of the shotgun. Rolling out. Throws it downfield and almost intercepted by Quentin Newsom. That allows Logan Smothers now to lead this offense out onto the field for Nebraska. The sophomore quarterback is doing big things, or looking to do big things this year in his first starting season, as they get it to the freshman receiver, Vernon Wesley, all the way down the field. 6'4", 217 out of Mitchell, South Dakota, as Vernon Wesley gets it deep into Jayhawk territory, and Smothers is going to finish the job. Three plays, no problem. 7 points for this Cornhuskers offense and a quick 7-0 lead if they hit this extra point, which they do. First and 10 now. Jason Bean out of the shotgun. He's got Grimm behind the defense downfield. Beautiful pitch and catch there as Luke Grimm just finds the hole in the zone coverage now. Second and 7. Jason Bean going across the middle and it's dropped. Stephen McBride had a chance at it. But 3rd and 7 now deep in Nebraska territory. Going outside to Trevor Wilson. Can't turn upfield. Just gets about 2 on the 4th and 5 now. Going for it. Jason Bean gets the first down and a little more after about a 7-yard run up the middle. Now 2nd and 10, looking to do anything on offense. He's trying to escape the pressure and he doesn't. He's going to lose about 13 on the play. Isaac Gifford and company in the sack. Right there, Bean though, looking to throw. Going down the middle and it's almost intercepted. Miles Farmer made the big play earlier, and now he's going to get that one down, and a punt for that Jayhawks unit. Now Smothers and Irvin Jr. getting back to work. Gabe Irvin Jr. looks to carry this Nebraska offense, as he will have a dominant performance if there's any indication, as Xavier Betts gets a tough catch in traffic. 7-0 still as Tywan Berryhill makes a fumble. And it's going to be recovered by the Jayhawks. Tywan Berryhill interrupts the pitch on the option play and gets us that ball back. Just what the doctor ordered now. We have the ball and back on offense as Gardner still can't get anything going. Trying to get him involved in the offense any way he can. But 4th and 5 now later on that same drive. Little over a minute remains in the quarter. Jason Bean going to roll out. Got a lot of room downfield, and he's going to get the first down again. Now 3rd and 1 a few plays later. Gardner finally gets some open space up the middle for about 12 to 13 yards there. And that's going to end this first quarter, 3rd and 5 now, 7:25 and counting in this third quarter. It's going to be a pass play to McBride, and he breaks it upfield. 6 yards, but just enough for the first down. First and goal now. Jason Bean in the shotgun. He's going to throw it to Smith, who breaks the goal line. First down, touchdown, 6 yards to James Smith from Jason Bean. And Smith is making just the contributions we thought he would. Now 7 minutes remain in the quarter as Gabe Irvin Jr. has to be brought down by the lineman Caldwell from behind. He's had himself a massive game so far today. So has this man, Vernon Wesley, the true freshman with an 11-yard catch. 3rd and 4 now. Smothers out of the shotgun. He's going to throw it outside, and it's caught outside by Sean Hardy the second for 22 yards. Might have to review that one because that's a close call. But Sean Hardy for now, it's caught a catch, but they're going to review it and see if he gets a foot down, and he does not. Just like that, the momentum goes straight back to Kansas's favor as we are going to get the ball back on a punt, and let's see if we can do anything with that. Nebraska actually ends up kicking the field goal here. It's a long one, 4th and 4, all the way back at about the 40, and it's going to just barely inch in there. Jason Bean now and company with a 3rd and 10 back onto the field, struggling to get anything going, but Trevor Cardell, the new starting tight end, as Mason Fairchild did not progress as much as we would have hoped, but Trevor Cardell jumps him in the lineup and is able to get something going there. Deep downfield, and it's intercepted. Jason Bean had James Smith deep, but he underthrows it. And he has to end up making the tackle there as their first turnover of the season goes to Tyreek Johnson. Jason Bean starting out the year strong with that touchdown, and now he just can't keep it going with his first interception of the year. 1st and 10 now as Nebraska has a chance to take a big lead. Gabe Irvin Jr. breaking anything that he comes into contact with. 6 yards there. He's already got 42 rushing yards. 2nd and 4 now. Smothers is going to throw it this time. No problem there. He's got Nixon again. Will Nixon with about 24 on the play. 1st and 10 deep in Jayhawk territory. Irvin, who else would get it? Running up the right side all the way down to the 3-yard line. 1st and goal. Give it to Irvin again. Breaking a tackle and into the end zone. He just threw Gavin Potter right off of him for that touchdown. His first of the season. Now 2nd and 2 on the next possession. Jason Bean looking to run it outside, and he's got some space downfield for enough for 15 yards. It's going to bring up a 2nd and 6, 1:34 remaining as Gardner just drops it. They're trying to get the ball into Velton Gardner's hands. Get him to make some plays, but unfortunately they just can't get the ball to him. But this time it's intercepted again. This time it's by Farmer, the other cornerback, as Jason Bean has to make the tackle there as well. He tries to throw outside again, and it's intercepted again. Logan Smothers back onto the field with a little over a minute remaining. 17-7 is your score as Gabe Irvin Jr. gets a first down there. Smothers out of the shotgun. Jayhawks bring pressure, and he's sacked. Brought down by Steven Parker, the new defensive lineman who was redshirted last year and looks to have a big impact this year. 3rd and 9 now. 1 minute remains. Smothers throwing it to Will Nixon, but he can't get the first down. So once again, the Cornhuskers are forced to settle for 3. 4th and 3, this one's from the 30-yard line, and it is going to sail right. No good. He hit a 51-yarder earlier, but here we are in the second half now. Jacob Borsea gets us underway. 17-7 after that late missed field goal. Marquise Stepps got a lot of room to return this one, though. Going downfield, finally going to be pushed out of bounds after 70 yards. 2nd and 4 on that drive. Irvin gets enough for the first down. just barely falls over top of it. That's going to be another first down for him. 75 yards on 12 rushes. They give it right back to him. Two missed tackles. Irvin finally brought down at the 1 yard line. He gets 16 on the play. Second and goal. Give it to Irvin. His second of the day. 1 yard touchdown run there as Gabe Irvin Jr. makes the Nebraska lead even bigger. 24-7 now as Kansas comes back onto the field. Trevor Wilson makes a nice outside catch there for first down. Luke Grimm this time on the quick slant for 7 yards. It's now second and three. Jason Bean under center this time throws it outside to Cardell. 4 yards on the play. Need to get him more involved, they said. So let's give it to him again for another 8 yards there. First down. Later, a few plays. Third and 12. Jason Bean out of the shotgun. He's going to go to Cardell again. That gets enough for a fourth and one. And, I mean, you've got to go for it in this situation as Jason Bean gives it to Velt and Gardner up the middle for a first down. Bringing up a second and goal now, just one play later. Velt and Gardner gets a little bit of space, and he runs into the end zone untouched for a 3-yard touchdown run. And that gives us a 10-point deficit now. Smothers and company back on the field as Will Nixon had a good 30 yards on that play, but he drops it. This time it's a screen to Irvin Jr., can't get him down, and he gets the first down. Keenan Caldwell missed the tackle, and now it's second and eight a few plays later. Finally brings Smothers down for a sack. Unfortunately, he falls forward to the line of scrimmage, but Steven Parker gets his second sack of the day, and we force the punt. Now Trevor Wilson looking to return it here, just can't break it open. Now we're going to go into the fourth quarter. First play of the fourth goes to Velt and Gardner, who fights forward for that first down. Down by 10 still, though. First and 10 now. Going to look the pass, and he's got Steven McBride for the first down. A 12-yard catch there as he's hit kind of hard on that reception, but he holds on to the ball. Jason Bean looking to protect it, not turn it over again this drive. He struggled all game long. Second and 4 now. It's going to be a pass again to Steven McBride, who gets lit up there. Now second and goal after a few yards were lost on a run. This one's a pass to Trevor Cardell, who breaks the plane. A very anticlimactic touchdown, but apparently he breaks the plane with that one, and we're down by 3. Jayhawks offense is finally cooking as Gabe Irvin Jr. just cannot be stopped at all today. Logan Smothers out of the shotgun now on 3rd and 1, throws it outside and it's dropped. Will Hardy Jr. had a chance at it, but the Jayhawks are going to get the ball back deep in their own territory with a chance to tie it or take the lead. As Jason Bean there on first down was able to get a nice little scamper on the read option straight up the right side. This time, though, out of the shotgun, it's going to be a pass to Trevor Wilson. He's got the outside, and he's going to be pushed out of bounds after 17 on the play. 2nd and 8 now. Bean rolling outside. He's looking to throw. Got a man in that Steven McBride up the middle for 9 yards. 3rd and inches now. A little over under 2.5 minutes remain as Devin Neal with his second carry of the day. Gets 3 yards on the play. 2nd and 6 now. They give it to Will Huggins trying to go up that right side. It's going to be 3rd and 6 now. That was Javon Wright on the tackle. 3rd and 6. Jason Bean looking to throw. He's going to scramble outside. Back across his body, and he gets James Smith, who falls for the first down. 2nd and goal with 50 seconds left. Jason Bean rolling out, looking to throw, and he's sacked. Loss of 9 on the play. Just what you couldn't do if you're the quarterback there. That brings up a final game-tying field goal with 15 seconds left. Jacob Borcia, it's up and it's no good. He misses it wide right, and his struggles from last year continue into this season as the Cornhuskers end the game with a 3-point victory, and your Jayhawks fall in the first Season 2 game we've played so far. Not the best start to the season that we would have hoped to see. Jason Bean struggled all day long. He finally got it going late in the game, but it was just too little too late. Two interceptions in the first half. He was protective of it in the second half. Velton Gardner, 3.5 yards a carry. He struggled all game long to get anything going. Trevor Wilson, though, 7 for 70. James Smith had 4 for 37 and a touchdown. And Trevor Cardell had 6 for 58 and another touchdown. What a tough way to start this season. As you guys see, we were so close to pulling off the upset. Unfortunately for us, we just couldn't get that field goal to go. And before we end this video, I wanted to go around and look around what's going on in the league and have you guys be a little bit more involved in this series, season two and onward, because last year I kind of just, it was only Kansas and we didn't really care what else was going on. But I figured, hey, why not? We'll look at what's going on around the country. Obviously, as of right now, all these teams have only played one or two games because we did have a bye week after the game against Nebraska. So we've simulated a few weeks now, and everything looks to be about what you'd expect it to be, besides maybe Indiana. Indiana dropped drastically overall-wise, so they're still top 10 after a win against Northern Texas, but I wouldn't expect them to stay that way. Oklahoma did drop their first game of the season against Tennessee, so they fall to 0-1 early on. Michigan's up there at 12 now. Utah and Georgia both take a loss. Georgia lost to Clemson, I believe. They have South Carolina next week, so maybe Carolina can pull off that upset. And other than that, nothing too crazy going on. Kansas State jumps into the top 24 now after beating Auburn in overtime last week. UCF makes their first appearance of the season. And teams that dropped out would be Michigan State and Nebraska, who apparently lost their next game after playing us. So interesting to see what goes on there the rest of the season. As far as conference standings go, pretty much every prediction had us finishing last. As of right now, we are sitting dead last. We haven't played any conference games yet, and we won't for a few weeks. But either way, I think we'll be fine to not finish last. I think hopefully finishing in the 6-5, 6-7 range would be best case scenario for us. And before we end this video, I want to go check out if old Jalen Daniels is playing for California. I'm not sure if he's even going to be the starter, so I don't really know why he transferred there, and he is not. It's going to be freshman Kai Milner. So Jalen Daniels transferred into California to play behind a freshman, so take that with a grain of salt when I tell you he transferred to get some playing time. And our recruiting is going fairly decent. We've got a couple of guys. Jerry Rollins is a 79 overall middle linebacker. He's minus 885 for us. But I believe if we can make it to the visit, then I think we'll be able to get a lot of points off of that visit, because we've got the perks and the stuff to get extra bonus points on every visit. So we've got him in play to come to our school. A couple of guys we're going after, Lauren Bullock and Kyle Patterson. You can never have too much receiver depth in college football. Then we've got two pretty nice tight ends, Kevin Johnson and Ryan Hart, two three-star tight ends, both 67 overall. They're going to be pretty decent if we can bring them in. We've got Daryl Fuller, 65 overall, tackle. So he should be decent if we can bring him in. Guard-wise, Franklin Holmes, 67 overall. And other than that, there wasn't too much to look at here. Bruce Dixon and Dwayne Hayden would just be there for depth. Dane Lewis at the center position, a 68 overall, would be a nice depth piece there. We don't really need a center too much, but you're not going to turn down a guy like that. As far as these positions go, outside linebacker, we've got Ross Rushing, a 70 overall, three-star prospect. We're probably going to be able to bring him in. We're up by 1,000 on the next team. Then we've got Lee Pope and Calvin Lane, two guys that would be massive for depth and for playing time. As we saw earlier, Jerry Rollins, middle linebacker. Ricky Moore isn't quite as good as Jerry Rollins, and we're about 300 less on him, but I think if we can make it to the visit time in the top five, we can jump up there pretty easily. Cedric Baldwin and Chris Mosley are there to round out the middle linebacker positions just in case we need somebody else in. And the biggest part I wanted to see is these two guys right here, Mike Johnson, a five-star athlete, and Dustin Newberry, a four-star athlete. These guys would bring us over the edge, I think. They're both just insanely talented, can play multiple different positions. So I think this would really help us to improve next year. And I really think that we need to bring these guys in if we want to do something next year with this class. So let me know who you guys are most excited for us to recruit, if it's a running back, a receiver. I'm mostly excited to see if we can bring in those athletes and Jerry Rawlins. That would be amazing. But the real question is now, where do we go from here? After the first loss of the season coming in week one again, two back-to-back week one losses in both years so far, we do take on Charlotte, who beat us week one last year. Overall-wise, we've got a much better team, but statistically, they're better than us, and they had the advantage last year. We're going to be going to the Kansas Stadium. We're going to be at home. So I hope that we'll be able to pull off this ugly matchup. And let's see if Jason Bean can just next episode avoid the turnovers. Velton Garner needs to get going. And we need to stop Evan Sheriffs this year if we can. So that's really all I've got to say for this episode. I hope you guys did enjoy. Welcome back to the series after a few days off. I can't wait to make more of these videos. I don't know if I'm going to start a new series or not. I'm starting classes back for my school in a couple of days. So I haven't decided on that. But if not, this series is always going to be posted. I enjoy making it, and I know you guys enjoy watching it. Make sure to hit the like button, subscribe, and just follow my social medias down below in the description. That's where I post everything to keep you guys up to date. Thank you guys so much for watching my videos, and I'll see you next time when we take on the Charlotte 49ers.